What's up, guys? This is Dr. Webb here. Thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe. New videos coming every week. You don't want to miss them. In this video today, I'm going to be talking about how I memorized everything in medical school as well as residency. Medical school is very challenging. Some people compare it to trying to drink from a fire hydrant. Or one of my professors in medical school stated that learning in medical school is like trying to throw mud on the wall. You're gonna have all this mud that's been thrown at a wall, but only a small portion of that mud is actually gonna stick. And in order to get more mud to stick to the wall, you have to throw more mud at it. If you compare this to medical school, you have all this information in such a short amount of time to learn it, and then you try to learn this information. The more times that you repeat this information and reinforce this information, the better and the longer it's going to stick with you. So in this video today, I'm going to give you five kind of specific and easy tips to help you memorize, whether you're pre-med, whether you're in medical school, whether you're in residency, or even if you're out already and you're studying for something else, this video is going to be for you. So here we go. So there's five R's that I came up with to help you memorize everything that you're studying. And this can be applied to anyone who's in law school or in business school, pharmacy school, whatever school that you're in. These particular steps and keys can help you be successful. It helped me be successful in medical school and helped me get to the point where I'm at today. So I wanted to share it with you guys. So the first R is to have a routine. In medical school, each day, if I didn't go to class, and majority of the time I didn't go to class unless it was mandatory, I got up at the same time every day and did the same exact thing. I got up, ate breakfast, and then sat at my desk by 6 a.m. and then studied until a predetermined amount of hours, whether that was later in the evening or half a day if we had clinical rotations in the evening time, or for more test days where we had to study a little bit more, I studied a little bit longer. So you got to have a particular routine, and whether you like to study at home and then you're better and more effective at home versus studying at Starbucks. So now, as a resident and studying for my orthopedic surgery boards, I can't stand to stay at home and study. In medical school, it was completely opposite. I had to study at home. I couldn't study in the library. So now what I do is I go to Starbucks or go to the library and I sit there and I study. And that has helped me be more efficient in my studying. So whatever routine that you have, whether you'd like to study in bed, and I did that a lot of times in medical school, I just stayed in bed and studied. Or if you like, you know, studying at home or at the library or school, find out what works best for you. Develop a routine and to kind of stick to that routine. This is going to help you in the long run. So the number two R that I have for you is to remember. You're going to have lots of information in whatever test that you're going to be taking. If you're taking organic chemistry as a pre-med, or if you're taking a sociology class for your particular degree, or if you're in business school taking a business class, you have to find a way to remember the information. And that's my second R. And the way I did this was I conceptualized. As I went through the material, I painted a picture in my head to help me remember that particular concept. And whether this was a drug that I needed to remember or a certain disease process, I just painted a picture. I took the time and I stepped away from my rest of my studying and I painted a picture in my head and I conceptualized it. So once you conceptualize, this will help you remember the information. I also use mnemonics. I had lots of different mnemonics. Some people learn with mnemonics, other people don't like mnemonics. Well, I love the mnemonics, and I came up with a number of them myself, and also I just Googled. Say, for instance, a patient has multiple myeloma. There's a mnemonic called CRAB, C-R-A-B. The patient has hypercalcemia, renal failure, anemia, and Bench-Jones proteins. And I've been out of medical school for 5 years, and I still remember that. That's crazy. So the third R, and the third tip that I have for you guys, is repetition. All the information that you have in medical school, and in medical school, you take a number of credit hours per semester. In college, you know, full time is 12 to 15 credit hours per semester. In medical school, you're going to be taking like 35 to 40 credit hours per semester, so it's a lot of information. In order to get this information down and to memorize it, to learn it well, to be successful, you have to have a system in place where you repeat the information and going over it multiple times before the test came around. I have another video about rolling review, and I'll put it right up here. But essentially, that was my kind of strategy in medical school to repeat the information so that I can get it in my brain before the test. So the fourth R and the next tip I have for you guys is reinforcement. After you go through all your material and you go through all your lectures and you're getting ready for your exam, you need to reinforce this knowledge with basically questions. And I always tell students, the more questions that you do on any test in your medical path and your medical career, the better your score will be. In medical school, for my step one exam, before I even sit down and studied for it, and they gave us 6 weeks to study for step one, where we didn't have to do anything but study for step, before that 6 weeks even started, I had already done 2,500 questions for step one. And each exam in medical school, I always reinforce the knowledge that I was learning with questions. And this can come from old practice exams. Some medical schools provide this. This can come from different preparatory courses like Kaplan or Princeton or Doctors in Training, UWorld, which we use a lot in medical school, or some questions that you come up with on your own. So in medical school, I had classmates that I studied with. I studied with three girls. So I learned a lot about females during that time. But in what we used to do is go through the materials and our PowerPoints and our lecture handouts and come up with questions. We would make questions just from the material. We would fill in the blank and get a sentence or a concept and leave a particular gene defect out or some type of disease process and make a multiple question test. And for the lectures or the tests that we didn't have practice questions available, we use these questions to study and reinforce our knowledge. So the last thing that I have and the last R that I have for you guys is recall lists. Like I said, in medical school, there's lots of information. You may have, let's say, 30 to 45 PowerPoints, with each PowerPoint having 30 to 40 slides on them. So it's impossible to go back through all of those notes, all those PowerPoint slides before your exam. So what I used to do and what I still do now is I come up with a recall list, and it's basically the high yield things that I think are important for the exam that I think I will forget by the time the exam comes around. So little small gene defects or medications and their mechanisms of action. It's not a comprehensive list of everything. It's things that I think are important and things that I think I will forget by the time the list comes around. So I'm going to go over my kind of recall list that I'm currently making for my orthopedic surgery boards, and I'm gonna go over it with you guys now. So this is my recall list here for the ABOS, American Board of Orthopedic Surgery. And if you could imagine, over 5 years of material from anatomy, from physiology, pathophysiology, from histology to different approaches in surgery, when a patient needs surgery, when a patient doesn't need surgery, some complications that can go wrong, the implants that we use in surgery, medications, there's a lot of material. So this right now is currently 69 pages, but over 5 years, that is not a lot of material to kind of condense down and know right before the exam. So like I said, a couple days before the exam, this is the only thing that I will be studying versus trying to learn everything or review everything once again before the exam. So I broke it down in different sections. This is the basic science section here. And things that I think I will forget, I'm listing that material on this document here. I'm also including pictures as well, things that help me remember certain things, and I'm a very visual person, so I need pictures. I have mnemonics in here, so, and then the different sections. This is spine, and I'm going through each particular section, and I'm putting x-rays in here as well, or anything that I think that will help me remember what's going on. Here's some arterial blood flow to the leg here, when we do a ACL, the different landmarks that we use. So this is what I will use to study, like I said, and I've been coming up with this list here for the last few months, and I will review this right before the exam. So in your particular exam, just come up with a composite list of things that you think are important, and right before the exam, you can remember and go over that list kind of multiple times to get those small details down. All right, so that is my recall list that I'm currently using for my orthopedic surgery boards, which I take in like 76 days. So a week or 3 to 5 days before the exam, that's what I'm going to be focusing on. Instead of reviewing everything that I tried to learn over the last number of months, I'm going to be printing out this recall list and then just going through these high yield things that I typed up. So these are my 5 R's that I have for you guys. You have to have a routine. You have to have a way to remember. You have to have some sort of system in place where you're repeating the information, trying to learn it and try to drill it in your brain. You have to reinforce the knowledge with questions and also pimping sessions, which means have your classmate or someone else ask you questions from the knowledge that you just learned, as well as a recall list. And I think all of these 5 things, the 5 R's that I came up with, if you do these 5 things, you'll be successful in any exam. This is Dr. Webb. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.